Bacteria. They're tiny little creatures that are essential to our survival, try to kill us on a regular basis, and are everywhere. In fact, you all have more bacteria than human cells on and in your body. And me, I probably have even more with the whole no shoes thing. Worth it, though. Worth it. One of these bacteria that we all have billions of in our gut and try to keep off our lettuce is E. coli. E. coli is what I work with, as it is the go-to organism to determine general bacterial behavior. And bacteria are the simplest life form, which makes taking a mathematical approach to understanding them more feasible than with other organisms. This isn't to say they aren't still incredibly complex, but under certain conditions, they behave simply enough to be able to characterize them by knowing only a few of their attributes. One of these attributes is growth rate. If you change an E. coli's exponential growth rate by changing its diet, you also change the average cell size, as you can see at the top of the slide, which depicts E. coli that are eating different foods of differing qualities, such that the largest ones are growing about 7 times faster than the smallest ones. Also, when you change their growth rate, you change other things, like the quantity of DNA and protein in each cell. Incredibly, all of these relations follow well-defined linear trends, like the solid blue line at the top of the graph. This is quite powerful and unusually simple for biology. So this got us wondering whether mutation rate, which is how often there's a change in an organism's DNA, also changes in a simple, quantitatively predictable way with growth rate. To determine this requires intricate experiments in which I grow a small number of E. coli cells for a defined amount of time in different foods, and then select for cells that have become resistant to an antibiotic through mutation. I then analyze the data and compare it to mathematical models to determine the E. coli's mutation rate at different growth rates. This is important because mutations are the driving force of evolution, and evolution is the driving force of life. So if we know that faster growing bacteria are more or less likely to mutate, as in the dotted green or dashed red lines respectively, then we can possibly gain insight into other aspects of evolution, like biodiversity and adaptation. We can also better understand antibiotic resistance and maybe use this knowledge to better combat superbugs. Like, if someone has an infection, we should be able to better determine how likely it is to evolve a resistance to antibiotics and can plan accordingly. Though we like to think of this as our world, bacteria are the oldest and most prevalent life form here, so really it's kind of their world. We should probably learn our master's ways.